We lost that game because of TV.
I find it hard to believe that you need weed to actually be good.
I just feel like when I smoke, I play. I play and see the court. That's how I look at it.
I look at it as just saying you needed to be better at the shit. Like, really, that's just... like,
hey, bruh, we shouldn't have lost that game. Why does it sound like there's somebody outside?
Ain't nobody ringing the doorbell, so...
I know, a lot of times my uncle over there, he'll sit outside, don't call me or shit.
And,
how do you expect me to know you outside?
And...
That's what I'm saying, how do you expect me to know that you're outside if you don't call me? Or if you don't ring the doorbell, you just be sitting up. Oh yeah, I know you can hear my you got a loud bass system. I know you can hear that. I'm not paying attention to that crap.
Let's start things off, Will. Show you how hard I've been training. And
are they gonna have updates for this game?
Good question.
Because I know it's gotta be more than these characters.
Bro. Look at all the spaces, though.
That's what I'm saying.
This,
I know it's gotta be more than here, just these
here,
characters.
Here. Look at all this shit. Look at all these spaces right here. Here. I know Android 21 is in my head somewhere, but I doubt people don't really give a shit.
That's what I'm saying. I feel like
it's gonna be more.
Yeah. At least 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. At least 9 more characters. I would love for Jiren to be one of those characters, but he might be too OP to be in this game.
Definitely.
They said they might put him in Xenoverse 2 before they put him in this game because they feel like he'll be too OP in this game. That's how strong Jiren is.
I'm not gonna be picky about who's gonna be in this game. All I want is
I'm saying though, how is both Super Saiyan Blues, Goku and Vegeta in this game, but Gold and Frieza isn't? It doesn't make sense.
That is a good question. What the fuck is Gold and Frieza?
It don't make sense. Why would they be in this game and Gold and Frieza isn't in
the game? He better be in the DLC or something. He better be in the DLC.
Or they should have made it to where he could transform in-game, you know what I'm saying?
That's what I thought when I saw the trailer. I thought so if Frieza's in here, he could transform for an ultimate, right? But apparently not.
That's what I'm saying.
Which is weird, because...
So that might mean Gold and Frieza might not be in this game at all.
I hope not. I want Gold and Frieza at least as a DLC.
But that'd be stupid to put two Friezas in the game.
They got four freaking Gokus and Vegetas, though.
I mean, I don't get it.
Bruh, they can have more than one of the same characters in this shit. They did it in Xenoverse.
It's stupid.
Back in Xenoverse, they did the same thing. They had
At least with Xenoverse, they had, presets where it was one character and then there were... You know what I'm saying? 6 that you could pick, and it's still one character. This is literally 2 of each fucking character, basically. That's stupid. And to me, that's just dumb. You could have used all spots for people you actually want to put in the game. All you had to do was make Goku, Vegeta one person, and make it to where they could transform while they're, you know what I'm saying, while you're in
What's
game.
Next? What's next? You're gonna have Rage Trunks over here, and then while the regular Trunks
then,
is over
then,
there.
Then the regular, you know what I'm saying, and the whatever the fucking Android side, it's just fucking stupid.
Yeah.
It's like they put characters from each
saga.
Yeah, from each saga in this game.
They kind of did the same thing in Xenoverse 2 at some point, but not this obviously.
But yeah, it wasn't this obvious. It's like, in Xenoverse, they only did that for a few amount of people. They doing this shit for everybody down there. See, that's what I'm saying. Okay, they got Fat Boo. Where Kid Boo at?
Right there.
See, it's 2 versions of fucking Boo. Well, I mean, it's always been like that for Boo, but...
But see...
Why the hell is Captain Ginyu on here? I don't understand.
Yeah, these two right here, they can do without. I'm pretty sure they can do without, depending on the rest of the roster they got.
I don't
right
know
here.
Why they always put them in games, bro. I understand they were a big part of the Dragon Ball Z saga.
The early sagas.
Yeah, the early
sagas.
But to be honest, they really haven't done anything in Dragon Ball Z. So to me, they meaningless characters.
All they did was just come back just to die again.
You know what I'm saying?
Nappa came back in GT, died again. Ginyu came back in Super.
Nappa came back in GT?
Yeah, you remember there was this little, there was a little clip in GT where Nappa just destroyed the whole city for a minute, and Vegeta was like, you better get out of here unless you want to be killed by me again.
I remember that. I'm about to say pull it out, because I don't remember Nappa coming back in GT. He looked the same?
Yes.
Dude, was look, he able to go su- No, he wasn't.
Fuck
able to
go no.
He's
no
that day. Fucking weak. He, this is what, 20-something, 30, 40 years later, this nigga still can't go fucking Super Saiyan?
I mean, what'd you expect? He died when he was still kind of weak as fuck.
It's tragic, man.
I'm like, what? If Nappa were to go Super Saiyan, how would you tell it the fucking difference? He got no damn hair.
His eyebrows. And his fucking mustache.
Okay, you got me. Hold on a second. GT, Nappa, let me see. See, look.
How the hell did he come back? Did he get wished back or something?
You remember what happened to GT? This was during the Super 17 shit with all the, when all the villains broke out of hell.
Oh.
And Nappa was one of them, of course.
Nah, he do look a little different. It looked like they made his mustache like a little thinner or something. That's the Vegeta I like, that look he had then. I love that Vegeta. The look that they gave that Vegeta with the short hair and all that, I love that Vegeta.
Like the base Vegeta in GT.
Yeah, I love that Vegeta.
I'm surprised he wasn't ever a playable character.
Didn't he eventually grow a mustache in GT too, didn't
that's
he?
How we, that's how he came in, but he shaved it off.
He was like, why are you laughing at my mustache?
Yeah, it turns out like it's been what, ten years later, and he suddenly has a mustache.
That's what, remember when I was telling y'all in GT he had a mustache? That's what I was talking about.
I know, and then I couldn't really believe it until I actually saw this shit. And
yeah,
I was like,
he had a mustache in GT. Then he cut it off because people kept clowning him about it.
I don't see why.
Because this nigga's never had a mustache, and all of a sudden this nigga, 50 and 60, now he all of a sudden wants to grow a mustache.
I mean, hell, like, we don't know how old this dude is, really.
To be honest, we don't.
We don't know how old he is.
This nigga could be trillions of years old.
this dude looks at least like he's still somewhere in his mid-30s, but he's really like 80-something. And we don't even know it.
No, I think they really like 50-something, but they look 30-ish. Because I think they said in GT they were like 40-something then, wasn't it? I'm pretty sure.
I don't know if they actually said what age, but it sounds about right.
I've looked up like insider stuff and all that that talks about, you know what I'm saying, Dragon
like,
Ball
let's,
Z.
Let's think about this for a minute. Let's think about this for a second.
And they said that Akira Toriyama says that it could be possible like in GT that they were around the ages of like 40-ish.
But Vegeta is older than Goku.
Yeah, so it was.
So he's got to be at least 50 or something, like, right?
Nah, I think they said Vegeta is only like 5 or 7 years older than Goku.
Five or six or seven years older than him.
I think so. Yeah, cause remember
he didn't look. He didn't look like that in the Bardock movie from what I was.
Remember,
watching.
He
looked at least 10.
Remember when Goku was first born and you saw Vegeta as a kid.
He looked at least 10. I was gonna say 10. He looked kind of like 10 something.
I don't know. He might have been like 8 or 9 or 10 something. Like all I know is I know Vegeta is at least 5 years older than Goku.
I was shooting for 10 really, but
so
yeah.
That means Vegeta is older than Broly too.
Yeah.
Just noticed it.
Yeah. Even though they're both pretty much bigger shit compared to him, which is sad. But
yeah, that's something else I noticed. Like
Broly.
Vegeta is so small.
This dude cannot grow for shit, but he's still strong as fuck. But
Vegeta is real small.
So Vegeta is probably like what 45 or 40 something ish. Then Goku's probably like 40.
Mm-hmm.
And he still looks like 30-something, and they both still like they 30-something-ish or
but
something.
But you never know, though. Vegeta actually might be 50 now. I'm talking about in, like, Super, though. Because you got to remember, at the end of Dragon Ball Z, they were fucking old. They were late 30s at the end of Dragon Ball Z. It's gonna tell them how old they really are.
I want to say 50, really. I really do
want to say 50.
I want to say 50 so bad.
Vegeta is probably about 50-something now in Super.
Because isn't... Let me think.
And if they 50-something, I'd probably say Gohan is it. Gohan probably 30 now, at least. For real.
He's already...
Because he got a kid and everything.
Goku's already a granddad and everything. Yeah, so he's already got to be like 50 as well, so...
No, he ain't... That's not possible. How can he be 50?
Well, I was just doing the ballpark.
Yeah, I was about to say, how can he be 50? That would mean that him and Goku was born at the same time.
Well, you're right.
So it probably means Gohan is like 30-ish. Mid-30s. So, I wonder how old what's his name be there? It's hard to find that out just because of the time skips and all that shit. Trunks.
Oh, Trunks?
It's hard. It's really hard to really know how old he really is.
Okay, well, it can't be that hard. See, the thing is, I'm pretty sure... Well, no, because Gohan is half Saiyan too. I was going to say, like, half Saiyan still age like regular. But then you got to consider, like Gohan. But in Super, if Trunks is like 24...
They said in Super, Trunks is 24?
Yeah. Think about it. Trunks came into the past the first time during the Android Saga. He said he was 17.
That was the first time he came back, right?
And then it's 7 years into the future when we ran into him again, so...
Yeah, that's right.
There you go. But then, he still looks young as shit.
I'm about to say, that character looks younger than the character when he came back the first time.
He still looks young as shit.
The character from... The first character looks way older than the second time he came back. The second time he
came back... That looks like 24. That looked like he was like 24 or some shit. Matter of fact, when I first saw Trunks, you would have told me like he's only like 17. I was like, huh?
That's what I said. The first time he came, he looked grown as shit.
Second time around, he looks like he's just finished high school bullying or some shit.
I don't know. Why do they do stuff like that?
I don't know. Context
is the first time around.
Anime does not do context.
Yeah, the first time around he came, he looked older than what the age they said he was.
He didn't look 17.
Yeah, and now...
He looks 17.
Now he looks 17, but he's supposed to be 25, 24.
I don't know. Like, that's pretty much the main thing about Trunks that actually disappoints me. He's not really his age, even though he looks... at a certain age. Let me hold on a second.
That's the main thing that disappoints me about anime, period.
Look at this. This dude doesn't look... I might fill in bad futures.
And he's supposed to be 17 right there. He looks grown as shit.
Like, come on, guys. Come on now. Let me handle this.
That dude look grown as shit. That's why I said, the second time he comes back... He don't even look 24, man.
At best, you can say he's 21.
And that's being generous.
Yes.
Because to be honest with you, he looked like he about 17 or 18, to be honest. That second time he comes back.
At best, you can say he's 21.
That's what I said. Some of the stuff about anime, I don't be understanding.
Like the Saiyan aging features and everything is way more complicated than they need to make it to be. They're supposed to be like way older than what they look like. But the fact is that like it switches up on us. Like for one thing, how old was Goku when Dragon Ball Z started? When Dragon Ball Z actually first started the Saiyan Saga, how old was he back then? He had to be like what, at least 21? Probably 21.
At the end of Dragon Ball, how old was he?
Well, I'm gonna ballpark this. Gohan was 4 in the beginning of Dragon Ball, so I'm gonna say Dragon Ball was when it ended. He was at about like 17, because he was still Teen Goku at the time.
Yeah, I know he was. Yeah, so he had to be like 17-ish. So when Dragon Ball Z started, that was like a 5-year time lapse where nothing happened after the tournament, right? After Dragon Ball, right? So he probably had to be around
21 when the Saiyan Saga happened.
Yeah,
because think about it. Gohan was 4.
So it had to be almost like, what, 4 or 5 years had passed after the tournament?
So he was either like 21 or 22 something. And then you got a year later when the Sands came, he's like 23, yeah, I wouldn't say that. Then, the whole thing with the Namek saga.
How was he then?
The whole thing with Namek saga, it was almost 2 years, but just about 2 years after Namek blew up, so he's like 25 now. And then the androids, 3 years, 28. And then he dies again, so you got...
How long was he dead?
It's been 7 years, the Majin Buu saga, 7 years later.
They actually let him be dead for 7 years.
He didn't want to give a struggle with the Dragon Balls, remember? That was the end of the Cell saga. So, 7 years later...
So he must have had real faith in Gohan. That he could get the job done.
Which he could not.
Boy, I mean, he eventually did, but...
But boy, was he wrong.
I'm about to say, Gohan eventually got the job done, but... It took a hell of a lot for him to get the job done. Gohan had to see a lot of people die.
Oh yeah. Like, it's like, okay, like for a kid his age, he has went through some shit.
Oh yeah.
For a kid his age, he went through some shit.
That's why Chi-Chi used to didn't want him fighting and shit. That's one of the reasons.
Yeah, one of the reasons, really.
But that main reason, you know, she wanted him to go to school and all that shit.
Yeah, at the end, he's still there.
But I don't know why you think... I don't know why Chi-Chi thinks a fucking Saiyan will ever be a fucking normal human being.
Just because you live out in the mountains somewhere where nobody can find this motherfucker?
That's what I'm saying.
Gohan... Look how well that worked out for Goku.
Gohan will never be normal.
Look how that worked out for Goku.
Gohan will never be normal because there's always going to be a threat towards Earth, and they're going to need him. I pretty much believe that's why... I think that's why they don't even show Chi-Chi no more. Have you noticed that? They barely even show her now.
What you mean? In that Super?
Yeah. You know how, like, in Dragon Ball Z, every time they went off to fight somebody, she was either always around or she was telling them not to do this or not do that? Like, they don't even show that anymore. Because it's like, they know, like, or Chi-Chi knows. She's accepted what they are at this point.
You remember that time when Goku first left Whis to train and he pretty much had to, like, be like, Chi-Chi, like, bitch, get off me. I gotta go train. Like, yeah, and she's like, well, it was about to happen sooner or later.
Yeah, she's accepted it. I'm surprised it took this fucking long.
Like, but then you gotta think about the entire episode was like a week until Whis came back, and she's still constantly bitching at him about not wanting to go train. But a week later, it's like, well, it was about to happen sooner or later. I was like, bitch, how is it?
You want to know how she know it was bound to happen sooner or later? Because she know how Goku is. Goku is going to do what the fuck and he has to do, regardless of what Chi-Chi says.
And yet still, you still constantly trying to drive a wedge into this whole train and shit. Just because Pan's born now. But still.
She is not. That's not the reason that she didn't want him to train. That was just the excuse she was using.
But still, I'm just saying, like... It's like you went through all this shit, you know, knowing damn well it wasn't gonna work in the end. So what the hell? Why even bother?
She already knows the end game. Like I said, she knows Goku's gonna do whatever the hell he wants.
Like when it came down to Gohan, it was one thing, but Goku, hell no.
I'm about to say, and even in that, Goku still took Gohan and did what the fuck he wanted to do. even when she told him not to take him.
Yeah.
Well, really, he followed them there, didn't it? When they did the erratic shit, didn't he follow them there or something?
Well, what?
Remember when Gohan was like 4 and he seen that shit happen with Piccolo? You know when he was holding Raditz when Goku was holding Raditz, he got shot in the stomach and shit.
Oh, Gohan was still unconscious.
Now I'm saying, how did he get there? Didn't he sneak there or something?
Piccolo took him. Piccolo was like, I'm taking him to train because we need to be ready for these Saiyans, so I gotta train him to use his power that I just saw. Bye.
He was like, I need to unlock that untapped potential as quickly as possible.
Basically, yes. Like, oh, I was still unconscious, so he was like, yoink!
Alright, let me finish this. While we having strolls down memory lane.
That's basically what it is. It's basically a whole rant about what the Saiyan Saga once was.
Yeah.
And hence, that's where Gohan's childhood was. Like I said, for a kid his age, he went through some shit. It's amazing how he's managed to
get. For a kid his age, you know, he had to save the entire fucking planet.
Travel through space and shit.
You know how much pressure that is?
It's amazing how he even manages to have a day-to-day in high school.
You know how much pressure that was?
I would have expected PTSD shit or something during one of his classes.
You know,
he probably getting nightmares and flashbacks and shit about when Goku dies or when Piccolo dies.
You know how much pressure that man had on him when he fought Cell? He knew if he didn't defeat him, that was it.
Yeah. And then you have to be the one to fight. You have to be the one to fight Cell after you just watch your dad.
You just watched this. You watched Cell kill Vegeta and fucking Goku. If that nigga wasn't shitting his pants, I know something. For real, if I was in Gohan's position, I would have been shitting my pants.
I would never like
if... the strongest people that you thought were the strongest people that you know just got fucking obliterated, and now you gotta fight this man.
I would've been like, fuck that shit.
Riddance, goddamn it.
Fuck that shit, I'm done.
You know what I'm saying? That's why I said
I'm done.
I know he had a lot of pressure on him, bro. He wasn't nothing but a teenager.